The stamp tool adds rubber stamp-like comments, such as draft and for review, on pages of the document. While review comes preloaded with a number of stamps, you can also build your own. Go to Tools, Stamp, then Create Stamp. From the Create Stamp dialog box, enter the stamp's subject. This is the name that will appear in the stamp's list. The username is automatically entered in the Author field, but can be edited as well. From the Template drop-down menu, select a starting point for the new stamp. The Width and Height box determines the measurements of the stamp in inches. Other basic appearance properties are available, including text and line color, which sets the default color of the stamp's border. Make the changes you want and click OK. The stamp appears as a new document with a blue boundary box using the width and height measurements from before. You can also tell you're working on a stamp by checking if there's a stamp icon in the File Name tab at the top. At the top of the boundary, the measurements update automatically as you adjust the blue handles. You can edit the stamp just as any other markup using the Properties toolbar or the Properties panel. You can add dynamic text to your stamp as well, which automatically updates depending on the parameters set. Add a new text box. The Dynamic Menu button appears. If adding dynamic text to a plain text box, make sure the cursor is where you want the new field to be placed. Then click Dynamic. The menu pop-up reveals a few different options for the file, user, and date information. Click on the desired field, and the associated script will appear in the text box. Once satisfied, save the stamp. To add the new stamp, go to Tools, then Stamp. The new stamp will appear in the drop-down list in alphabetical order. Click on the desired stamp and place it on the document by clicking where you want it to go. The stamp measurements will be as specified earlier, but the stamp size and rotation can be adjusted just as any other markup.